here to... We're XJAYS, we're not proud people. We don't boast. But then, sometimes it's good to blow your trumpet. Especially if you have a type of trumpet that produces a very melodious tune. I'm here to... With these citations about speakers in the past, I want to proudly talk about the young man that just talked to us. Proud man, no go now. And a proud man is my own classmate. 14th of September 1981, we admitted into juniors. And I know him for one thing. He's always on top of his game. Way back in our school days, a master dribbler, he was playing both junior and senior. I didn't know he would get up to this height in stature, honestly speaking. So proud man is making us proud. I know that the era of storytelling in the insurance company is gone. And Axad Mansard has never told us stories. They have paid their claims at the right time, courtesy of our proud man. I've been telling people, insurance does not mean, in Lagos, it is difficult to convince people about insurance. In my good ministry, they say, I shall not die. I shall not die. It has been written. Yes, it's written, but life and death belongs to God. So I call on us. Those of us that have not joined the insurance, the group life assurance policy of our SG, I don't know what we are waiting for. Can you say the rest of them and rest of them? They are not worse sinners than any of us here. But God said, your assignment on earth is done. If he says it, you can't, there's nothing you can do about it. So please, I join Abbott and of course the ESCO to wake up those of us that are still, you know, contemplating whether to join or not. Remember that if anything happens, we are on your own if you do not join. So please come on board. So Abbott, thank you. We're proud of you.
Thank you, my senior co-MC. And sir, it is a small one, let me say, to fit direct from Nigeria to London. I know, no matter how they visa, they do press up. You know, if you get muscles like crocodile, you know what I mean? Are we ready for the Zoom?
Yes.
We have to relax to enjoy this Zoom, you know? Feel at home, now you want to make visitors spoil remote.
I will be. I'm ready to put this fucking thing out of my head.
Marist Brothers Juniorate, your alumni, this afternoon, I make an important. I want to thank you for, you know, putting together this event. Now, I want to talk, the broad theme is about the role of alumni associations, and that's a very important aspect of our development as a society. But I want to talk a little bit beyond that. I want to talk about, you know, the role of the development of Nigeria, because many of you are young people. And I'm saying that the future belongs to you. And you should colonize that future and stop living in the past. What is the future? What is the past? The future is a state that is yet to come. When that state comes, it may be better than today, it may be the same as today, or it may be worse than today. If you go back in time to, let's say, 1975, that is today the past. If you were alive in 1975 and you had you were mature enough to think about the future, I think many people would have imagined a future in Nigeria that is far better, or was far better, than the situation in Nigeria in 1975. Okay?
Yeah.
Now, if that was the case, and you are alive in Nigeria today, many people would think back to 1975 and say, oh, life was better then. There wasn't two too much inflation. The naira was more powerful than the dollar. With 500,000 naira, you could buy a car. All of that, people would think back and say that the past is better than what we're experiencing today. The situation we have in Nigeria today is a situation going backwards to a time that seems better than today at the beginning of the record. The reason this is so, instead of what we have to say in Western countries, what you have in Japan, what you have in Germany, what you have in America, you find a situation where their future, they are creating a future that is oftentimes better than the past. They want to have technology. They use technology to organize us. The economies are going to expand the passive. So, they have choice people. And who owns the future? The people who are young, they have been clean. That is not the solution. The solution is that the young men and women of Nigeria must stand back, stand their ground and fight for their future. And there is no getting away from getting involved in politics in order to claim that future. Because it is the government that you elect, that decides what your future will be like. So, this is a call to young people. No matter what you do, no matter what your alumni association is doing, no matter what business you're doing, no matter what entertainment you're watching and enjoying, it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, the ultimate decider of the kind of future you have is the political process in anything that is supposed to be a democracy. So the sooner that young people begin to engage in it, the better. None of us have this kid and amen. Oh, there will be election boycott, there will be election boycott. This is the reason people are so politically marginalized in this country. They are busy marginalizing themselves. If you marginalize yourself, those you are competing with will help you to marginalize yourself. It is in their interest. So when you walk away from the election, say you will vote, So, these are the issues. Let me wrap up. I didn't want to speak for too long. I just wanted to point the mind and the attention of our young people to where the solution of our problem as a society lies. Some of us are in politics in order to create for the youth of this country the vision and the future that belongs to them, that should rightfully be there. We're not doing it because of any other thing. We're not doing it because I'm not here because I'm looking for a job. I'm running for president of Nigeria. I ran in 2019, and I hope to run again in 2023. I'm not doing it because I'm looking for a job. That God has placed in my path, in my heart, for the young people of this country. And I have four young men and women in my house who are my children. So what is my vision for the youth? Let me conclude with it. I have a 7-point agenda, my director. Number one is that if I were to become president of Nigeria, one of the first things that I will do is to create a 1 trillion naira venture capital fund together with in partnership with the private sector. What would be the purpose of that fund? And the private sector will run the fund so that it is run as a proper business. Anything that the government runs in our society becomes free and with money. That's the way everybody looks at it. And it will never be efficient and it will always fail. So what we will do as a government is that we will invest 500 million
private sector will bring 500 million. And that's to start. Fund can go to 5 trillion. That fund will not give loan to people. It will give them equity. The choice is no business. The fund will help to train people with the skills that can create jobs. And it will then give them equity money, but the fund will be a co-owner in your business. You don't have to pay back any loan with high interest rate. But the fund will be a co-owner in that business for some years at least, while you grow it. And if you make profit, you buy them out. As that business grows, not every business will succeed. Some will fail. This is the wrong marketplace. But if one succeeds, which is the most obvious, because it is the private sector that creates jobs everywhere in the world. It's not the government that creates jobs. The government creates a
fire
that enables job creation by the private sector. Today,
Kilo.
What's up?
Get back on that.
Government calls for a lot of experience. Good governance calls for experience. And people have to learn. So inclusive governance is very important. The next thing will be leadership mentor. We will depend on our leaders. That's the part of this program. Leadership is what the government progress is the one that you measure for the leadership.
We started getting someone like Professor Muoghalu to talk to us. Prof, we are happy. You've made our day, honestly speaking. And some of us will go to town today bragging that we brought you to our events. Our Lord Jesus Christ in the Bible talked about the difference between a shepherd and a wolf. I think we've listened to a shepherd speak. You know the difference between a shepherd and a wolf. We are mature, we are intelligent enough to know that a shepherd has just spoken to us. You are different from the rest, honestly speaking. This is one opportunity I'm looking forward to. I want to assure you, Prof, not only that you have increased your support base today, you've inspired some of us to think like you, to reason like you. And our promise is that LJs are not going to fail you, we're not going to fail the society. When we talk about youths taking over, I think we are talking about LJs. We are reasoned, we are determined, and we are going to deliver. We thank you most sincerely for making our time. Can you imagine an international figure? I know how you are, I can just guess how you amount your time. Minute by minute, but you give it to what to carve out this time for us. On behalf of Marist Brothers Juniorate Association and on behalf of the Marist Brothers Juniorate of Nigeria, we wish to say thank you and wish you all the best in your career. Thank you.
He's an outreach and communications director he's an outreach and communications director at the African Technology Policy Studies, the UK. He's a business transformation lead at Kent Community Health, NHS Foundation Trust, UK. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Honorable Engineer Ambrose Warden.
Thank you so much for that wonderful introduction.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to be here, and all thanks to Edoze Ilekwe, who just introduced me. Edoze is a good friend, my in-law, and as most of you will know, he's also a serial entrepreneur. If you're struggling with your business, he's the man to go to. I'm so pleased this afternoon to hear most eminent persons that have spoken here already, including Professor Muoghalu, raising the big point around mentoring. And before I forget myself, please permit me to stand on all existing protocols. Mentoring is vital in modern society, and it's something that I am very, very passionate about. My topic, which is around the theme of the event, is using mentoring as a catalyst for change, and how we can use this in developing leadership, entrepreneurship, and networking. It is a great pleasure to be amongst you today to add my voice to this wonderful event. I greet you all in the name of our God, the God of Jacob, the God of Isaac, and the wonderful God of Abraham. This event offers a unique opportunity to the Marist Brothers Juniorate to come together and explore how you can synergize to make an impact amongst yourselves and beyond. This occasion is particularly important, as I believe that vision has been on, which has been on since yesterday, showcased the diversity of skills, knowledge, and practical perspectives, especially as we pivot towards innovation as a key driver of economic diversification and recovery post-COVID-19. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to share with you my experience of using mentoring as a catalyst for change and its impacts on leadership, entrepreneurship, and mentoring. Please permit me to take this practical approach, as I believe it will add more value to this discussion. As a person who spends his days in the working world, it makes sense to me that in January, which is usually the time to set goals for how you develop yourself and your team during the year, it is also a great time for adults to be thinking about finding professional mentors. Adding mentoring to formal education and training can be a catalyst for remarkable change. A mentor in the professional realm is someone who provides advice rooted in experience with no expectation for anything in return. However, mentors do reap the internal reward that comes with helping another person to learn and grow. Mentoring is an ancient concept. The concept dates all the way back to the time of apprentices, when a wise business owner or a tradesperson took on an inexperienced person under his or her wing to grow them for the business or trade they were in. In this part of the world, it is recognized as one of the key drivers that lifted our region out of poverty post-Nigerian Civil War. Mentoring relationships have evolved naturally in businesses and organizations for as long as people have worked together. Common sense tells us that in order to have a fruitful mentoring relationship, there needs to be mutual respect and admiration between the two individuals. Without it, the relationship doesn't last, and the individuals don't flourish. So, when people naturally gravitate towards others based on this, it is often the best type of mentorship. One of my first professional mentors was my operations director. I didn't ask her to mentor me, and she did not offer to mentor me. But sharing was in her nature, and since I was part of her team, she had an inherent motivation for me to succeed. I felt supported, valued, and I could go to her for anything. I would not have called it mentoring at the time, but in hindsight, that is exactly what it was. It was key to my growth up the management career. By the mid-1990s, it was common in large organizations to find structured mentoring programs. Many are still in place today. This is where the company matches up mentors and mentees and provides training and support to ensure the relationship is successful. These programs are designed to attract new employees, develop leaders, and improve satisfaction levels of current employees, thereby encouraging retention. Over 20 years later, bring it up to speed. Today's mentor relationship have taken on a new look and feel. Join me, let's have a quick look at it. Relationships are driven by the mentee these days. Accountability and humility are the key factors of success in formal and informal mentoring relationships. When the individual who is being developed has 100% ownership, resistance is minimal or non-existent. The person's humble and clear desire for support, actions taken towards finding it, and their openness to receiving advice is the secret formula for success. The individuals often are physically remote, as we are in today's world. Many mentors never meet their mentees in person, travel and mentoring relationships. Several of my current mentees are individuals who I never see and only reach out to occasionally with specific advice. With the explosion of connection tools such as LinkedIn, Zoom, WhatsApp, etc., there are very few barriers to finding someone who knows what you want to know. Mentors and mentees may not know each other. Many of my mentors as a technologist are experts who share their expertise via online platforms. And because I listen to their words of wisdom and regularly over time, I get to think that I know them close. It makes me feel like I know them. It was actually one of them that pointed out to me the fact that mentors can be people you never met. Has anyone here heard of René Carreyrou? No? You need to find a book called Spike. Spike stands for Strengths Positively Identified Kickstarts Excellence. He's been mentoring me for years, but we have never met. He's a global actor in that environment. Spike. S-P-I-K-E, René Carreyrou, R-E-N-E-C-A-R-Y-O-L. Multiple mentors are common. It is now common to have many people that one may consider his or her mentor. Some may be structured as traditional mentor relationships, while others are informal and ad hoc mentors. Mentors could also be found anywhere. Anyone who has experience with something you're struggling with can be a mentor. This is not limited to someone who is significantly older than you or has more years in the business than you do. It may be someone much less experienced than you are in the field, but they might be more seasoned in a particular area. My daughter often serves as my technology mentor, because she is more exposed to the modern applications. So I'll go to her and say, Chichi, what is new? Because that is where they stay, spend their day all day, even though I'm a technologist, I have my only area of expertise. Let's look at the tricky areas in focus, which is leadership, entrepreneurship, and networking. One, mentors are an integral part of leadership development. A good mentor should not only have knowledge, but should also be able to impart that knowledge in an effective manner. They are expected to show enthusiasm and sincerity to help others succeed in life. Even though they are experts in their respective fields, they should respect the mentees. Mentoring can be used as a strategic tool to shape people so they can fit into organization's culture. This is important since a good leader first needs to have a 360 degrees knowledge of the organization. Two, a good mentor can help a fledgling entrepreneur think through strategies, crunch numbers, and create a business or marketing plan. His or her guidance can get you through rough times when your self-confidence may be waning and show you new perspectives and pathways to success. Mentoring ensures that knowledge, experience, and hard-won insight transfers from one person to another through personal interaction over time. While your own great ideas are essential to your new business, with an experienced mentor at your side, you will have one of the most powerful assets any new business person can ever have, and that is someone investing in you and your success. Three, in networking, it is all about building lasting, supportive relationships with people who share a common interest and goal. Building a network is a daunting and time-consuming prospect, but having a mentor can help you develop interpersonal skills and find career opportunities in industries and academia. Mentors can guide their mentees to be better at networking by training them to develop key skills like empathy. For this to be effective, the mentor will need to be intentional and have a strategy for passing the knowledge along. In addition, a mentee must also be prepared to work on their networking skills. Above are just the key pointers on how mentoring could be used as a catalyst for alumni associations like yourselves to play a role in developing both amongst yourselves and the Nigerian youth in general. To conclude, the following is an adaptation of a poem I came across recently, which captures one of the key factors for a successful mentoring relationship, and that is humility. Please, permit me to share with you. Dear classmates, some of us didn't further education after secondary school. Some of us furthered to university. Some of us got married. Yes, some of us are not married. Some of us are still struggling with life. Some of us are already settled. Some of us are still finding it difficult to eat two meals in a day. Some of us have traveled abroad. Some of us went back to the village. Some of us have seen real hell and still facing hell. Some of us are also dead, don't forget. And some of us, the last time they sat in the classroom was the last day we wrote our secondary school exam. In short, life is not good to everyone. Whenever you call or run into your old classmates, in general, please let the conversation be simple. That we are still alive is a thing to celebrate. Stop making your classmates feel less of a value because you're married, engaged, or have multiple degrees. Life is full of ups and downs, and life can turn around. You can stretch your hand and be a blessing to a fellow classmate. You can mentor them. And as my colleague David said moments ago, when you mentor them, you all win together. Life is not predictable. Be humble. Thank you so much.
Beautiful. Can I ask you guys a question? Okay, sorry, President. XJAYS.
Marist.
Okay, that's the completion. Okay. Thank God I've been paid my balance. I've been saying something different. Can I ask you guys a question? XJAYS. Assuming that 2023, you are asked to register your girlfriend. Yeah, boyfriend, wife. Let's just use girlfriend because we are still in the juniorate now. We are still there. So that's why I'm asking. If they do that, and upon you trying to register your boyfriend, and the machine says, sorry, the person you are trying to register has been registered, what will you do? Okay. How are you going to say you register another person? Or can you marry this? Thank you very much. So we are going ahead to our next lecture. And this one is on entrepreneurship education and the employment generation among the youth. Unemployment through entrepreneurship development. And to do this, I have to leave it for Josh to do that so that we can introduce the next lecturer. Thank you very much, Josh.
Thank you. XJAYS. XJAYS. Marist. Vincent Onodugo is a professor of management and currently the Dean, Faculty of Business Admin at the University of Nigeria, Enugu Campus. He is an alumnus of University of Port Harcourt, University of Nigeria, Nsukka, and Hagai Leadership Institute, Moai, Hawaii, USA. He is an organization and human development consultant and researcher of over 20 years experience. He has over 60 peer-reviewed publications in national and international journals. He is a peer reviewer in Cities and Pelion, published by Elsevier, and Sage, published by Sage Journals, among others. He is currently the editor-in-chief of Nigerian Journal of Management Research. He has attended over 100 workshops and conferences and presented over 300 papers in the process. He has conducted research supervised by Institute of Development Studies Geneva. He has consulted for the World Bank, UNIDO, PATS, US Aid Markets, SPAC, DFID, USAID, UNICEF, EU, AFRODAD, MUBIN, Central Bank of Nigeria, and National Planning Commission. He is an Associate Research Fellow of the African Institute of Applied Economics, now Afri Heritage Institution, Enugu, and Institute of Development Studies of University of Nigeria. He is also a Fellow of Nigeria Institute of Management, Fellow of Institute of Corporate Administration of Nigeria, Fellow of Institute of Industrial Administration, and member mandatory continuous mandatory continuous professional education committee MCPE of ICANN. He holds a master's degree and doctorate degree in the field of management, business management. He is certified by SAP and debt management. He is a certified SAP and debt management consultant. He is currently working on two areas, entrepreneurship education, employment, and employment generation among youth, and the exploration of the factors responsible for high mortality of family-owned businesses in Nigeria. Finally, I want to tell us that he is my PhD supervisor. Please, can we clap for him? Professor.
Thank you, my chief. Even for that introduction, your clap is too small. XJAYS.
Marist.
That's good. Given to me to be here, to be a part of this backbreaking summit by the XJAYS. I want to thank you for giving me the opportunity. My respects to the leadership of the Marist Brothers and leadership of XJAYS for this workshop and for inviting me. I will, because of time, I can see we compress too many things in one big summit, as it were. So I'm going to speak to the paper. I will not go the whole hog. That said, I'm particularly intrigued by the comment of the person who commented after Prof. Muoghalu said, made his delivery in the paper, He did say that one of the greatest achievements is to bring somebody in the pedigree of Muoghalu to come and speak to us. It's an achievement, but I would prefer, and that is that the greater achievement would be that we articulate a communique, an action point that we'll work on hereafter. If you look at the paper, just move. No. Each generation must act of relative obscurity, discover its own mission, fulfill it or betray it. I believe that we discover our mission and fulfill it. A lot has been said, a lot will still be said, but it's not talk is cheap. What is important is action. For a very long time, like I said, I'm not speaking, I will speak to the paper. In various fora, I grew up in this city. I happen to come from Enugu State. The chairman, I thought I was going to say it, happens to be my cousin brother, who are made professors the same day. I grew up in Enugu, and I found out the businessmen then were the likes of Ian Okike, the decamist, what's the one in Enugu? What's his name? And all of those people. Most of our parents were civil servants in Benue, Ko, and all of those places. They were civil servants. We grew up as civil servants, you know, what gives you the what places you in the pecking order is your level of education. We went to school. Some of us found ourselves in banks, in education, and all of those places. When I started out consulting, most of my clients, Joel, Roban, or Chris Hotel, the ones local, the one I mentioned there, the World Bank and all of those things, but I started with local people. 90-something% being random, social guest house, all of them, 90-something% were Nigerians. And incidentally, when I had the opportunity to talk to the people of it, I told them, they were 90-something%. We all grew up and find ourselves in glorified civil service environment, some in corporate organization, but we're still employees. The way the government is going, the way the society is going, public sector is shrinking and will continue to shrink.
Yes.
What is still holding this public sector is oil. No. And oil money is going to be the next 10 to 15 years, oil will lose its spotlight.
Yes.
What will drive the economy of Nigeria will be private sector development. And I will tell my people, if our future generation will not look up and begging for food, we have to do something about entrepreneurship. Breaking the frontiers of business to start, to set up business, to create jobs, rather than to train people to look for jobs. That's entrepreneurship. And let me say it all so clearly. Federal government, the greatest challenge of Nigeria today is insecurity. Hello?
Yeah.
If we have a secure environment, I can tell you, the whole world will come here to do in business. And the federal government for some time has been struggling using what they call kinetic approach. And I can tell you, with the statistics as it that the budget for the defense is 15%. Of total project. The budget for entire education is 5%. And these things are going to be deployed to generate hardware, gun, and all of those things. They cannot solve our situation. If you provide jobs, meaningful means of livelihood for these young boys, this place will come become peaceful. I think the non-kinetic approach, which is developing, creating job and wealth for young people, will stop this violence and insecurity to black aspect. And let me tell you, it's a hypothesis, but I can tell you in good authority that it has some level of credence to reality. Some of these people, mercenaries, I could call them, that were brought in to torpedo the regime of Jonathan. Maybe the promises were made. Maybe promises were not made or not kept. But however, in the course of their trying to get even with their paymasters, they suddenly discover that the means of livelihood, kidnapping people and banditry, as it is now being called, is more lucrative than whatever they were doing in it. I guess we need to find alternatives. But to find alternative, even the adult people, most of the poor people in that the Nigerian polity, as it is currently structured, has put them to the margin. And they're not getting enough. If we create a campaign environment and create job for them, most of these people will be off the streets completely. The key to all these things is create jobs for these young people and make the most of them. That's the key. Let's go. No, not just go a little bit. We will not go back. Let me tell you, the anvil, society shift. We are moving away from certificate-based society to competence-based society. Every entrepreneur, the greatest challenge you have is that you have unemployable people. Young people will say, I don't have employment, I don't have employment. I have a business. After a while, after consulting, I said, let me walk my own talk. And I hope that all of us will start walking our talk. I went and set up a farm. The greatest challenge I have is not money. The greatest challenge I have is not anything. The greatest challenge I have is to have reliable, dependable, skilled personnel. If we can produce these people, we will take the whole world. Singapore is where they are because of the quality of personnel. Let me tell you. Nigerian Americans are the most educated segment. Nigerian Americans are the most educated segment in the American demography. We have what it takes to take the whole world. And since we have moved away from analog to digital, the knowledge-driven society, if we process our young people wherever they are, I can tell you we'll take the whole world. A study was conducted. It was called, if you google it, you get it, Next Generation Project 2010. Okojiwala was the anchor partner. I did a little bit of work from the fringes. Yeah. Do you know the conclusion of that report? By 2030, Nigeria will be the nation with the largest number of young people. By that time, we'll be getting close to, by 2050, we'll be 400. Next to China. China will be following India. So, the conclusion of that report, and that's very important, Youths, not oil, is Nigeria's greatest asset. I look at Nigerians, we are very sound. It's not that we're developing our energies in the wrong direction. Hush puppy. For hush puppy to steal as much as he has stolen before one night. The world should stop us to understand him. Can you imagine the hush puppy and his team developing it, they put it in the ICT? They would develop the world. No. Hush puppy didn't see free steal from individuals, stolen from international organizations. Go to any competition, if Nigerians were there, you see that they will pops. When we went for leadership in Maui, in America, apart from Indians, Nigerians are the people who are taking this opportunity. What am I saying? If we process young people and make and give them the normal skills, the required skills, to take the whole world. What is wrong? Okay, that's the profile. Now, let's tell you three. No, good. 42% of, we have 42%, 42.5% youth unemployment. And we have 21.05 underemployment. That tells you, two of them is a little bit above 60. So more than 60% of our young people are idle or unemployed. Is it any wonder we haven't got courtesy and right individual arts? And Aduhan, they say. Internet fraud, Yahoo Yahoo, look at Hushpuff. Electoral talking and violence. If your fool is, you say they will be part of these things. They everything. Most of the adults mastermind most evils, but youths perpetrate them.
Yes.
Illegal migration and xenophobic attacks, drug trafficking and addiction. Do you know if you go to America, the most endangered species are the Nigerian Americans? Anywhere. You know why? Because the blacks feel. Yes. That's what is happening in South Africa. That's what's happening in South Africa. What's the same in Nigeria? They will come with a protein bag. Before you close your eyes and you open it, they take over the whole place. And you know, we are part of our problem, especially part of the people from the side. We are not also humble. We will not only finish that one, we'll go to the king and marry the daughter. Of the daughter. You know, Ghanaians in those days, when they were Ghanaians were here, they just go and buy small things, ladder. You know, some of them will even trek and be taking back their money. But we will not do. We go to the Zulu king and get the wife and even colonize the wife. So drug trafficking, addiction, kidnapping and all of those things. Let's go. Those who, because we are the ones spoiling our children, actually. We don't want them to suffer. We trekked 5 miles, fetched water, sold power, sold everything before we went to school. Now we take them to school, even when they're adults, we chaperone them. We follow them to market, and I don't know what we are doing. Some of them, if you throw them up, even in their neighborhood, they can't even stand. Some of us grew up in Gokan, we did all kinds of things. Because our economy is malstructured, at the time we were growing, before 2015, we were growing at 6% on the average. Yet unemployment was growing. It was a misnomer because the imperatives, the fundamentals were not properly structured, were not supporting employment generation. Ms. Gary Valusi said, okay, absence of coherent leadership and strategic plan. Do you know that Nigeria does not have any articulate coherent plan? There was a time we had Vision 2020 and all kinds of things. They were being kept in breach rather than in compliance. And we have this idea of policy reversals.
Yes.
Somebody will come, transformation agenda, throw away the other one. You know, seats, benchmarking, they throw it away. You know, so at the end of the day, there's no coherent plan anywhere. Except to develop chaplaincy.
building university of transportation in the desert. Difficult and harsh investment climate. Anybody who's in business, Nigeria is the most difficult place to do business. In fact, when I bought land for my farm, I had to pay people. When I started to take materials to build, you know, they block the place. They bought land somewhere and you want to pass it to our place, pay us. We went into negotiation. I finished paying 160,000 today. The next day, somebody developed mount ridges on top of that access road. I put a yarn with engines overnight. And in that community, if anybody plants anything, you don't touch it. And then two police to take everybody. Somebody said to take it easy. After the negotiation, they asked the guy, I said, what's your problem? He said, that money I brought, they didn't give him his fair share. I said, and they took it out on me. You didn't take it out on your people. So one thing led to the other. The man, a couple of months down the line, the man died. And I kept thanking God that I didn't take the man. Plus, they would have said, I was the one.
Yes.
Difficult, harsh environment. Businesses, mortality rate of businesses, you can't believe it. More than 80% of businesses die within the first 2 years of.
Yes, a bit.
Difficult. You provide your own electricity, provide your own everything. And then the people who are collecting tax don't allow you. You carry your things, they say you food and whatever. All kinds of people. You don't even know the number of taxes that are paid in this country. Or you start your own business.
Yes.
Just carry one pig and be moving. Then will... Oh, yes. Paucity of institutions to train and impart globally competitive skills. Debt of cheap, long-time investment. Look, let me tell you, you can't get low for investment in this company. It's shameful. What this every bank and all of them do around is they give you short-time loans. They use money markets, listen, to give you. So you can't do investments for which you pay back in 10 years, in 20 years. Yeah? Okay. Please, let's mark this opposition. We meet them to give us loans. We start paying back. They give you a material period of 5 years. We start paying back. Please, can we come back? Okay, let's go. Well, let's go. Well, folks, come on. Why are we bothered about promoting entrepreneurship? That's the only way we can break the cycle of dependence on states. You know, we are even shouting, let's have a Biafra. Even if they give you Biafra, those people who are looking for Biafra. All of us believe that Biafra is an ideology. But even if they give you physical Biafra, if you don't cease to depend on the states, you shrivel away. That's why on the states say, please, we must continue to latch on the feeling bottom of the federal government. We are not interested in you. We must break the cycle of dependence on the states, and that can only come through entrepreneurship. Ensure that our children do not look up in hand begging for food, I have mentioned this. Stem the tide of insecurity and violence, yes. Reduce the do or die attitude of political actors. Do you know, one day I was to speak in the Chamber of Commerce, maintaining political stability, through economic diversification. Let me tell you, we cannot stabilize our policy unless and only on. Do you know why people are willing to go and people are willing to go naked though? Provided they will get political appointment. You know why? It's a life and death. If you fail in everything and get more political appointment, you can break the cycle of poverty. Professors will soon go looking for local change. The salary of a professor is about 400,000 naira. But if you look at local change for 1 year, you can steal enough as much as this, if you are modest.
Yes.
100 million. The only way we can, that's why people, and they say, but nobody will be able to prevent it. Let us reduce the shine on this office. Let's reduce the sources in this office. But they will not be agreeing. People who will do it, they are not
agreeing.
Do you know that the capital project to renovate the National Assembly is more than the whole project for education? More than something billion to renovate an existing building. The whole university is ASUU will go on strike for 9 months, and we give them just a few drops of billions.
Mosquito net, 200.
Oh, you cannot enthrone peaceful, just, progressive, and value-driven society unless we deal with the issue of unemployment. Some people, for the sake of hunger, you know there's a level of survival. If you're operating at the level of survival, you can do anything.
Yes.
But man is self-preservative.
Yeah.
At the point of dying, you can clutch at straws to do anything. People will say, look, if you don't give me this money, you won't take the money you work for government. You do government contracts. Mm-hmm. You are supposed to pay 10 million.
Yeah.
Everyone will say you must bring 6 million. Mm. I'll bring 6 million before I give you 10 million. Or I'll give you 4 million. You get the money, you bring it in bank before I give it to you. And look at it. Hunger is dealing with you. You're not paying people who give the work. If you look, some of people out of frustration will just do something. Just leave me, make I go. Let's go. Listen. No, Go back. How do you know there is a business opportunity? Like I said, look for every challenge. Do you know Nigeria is the place you can do business? Everything in Nigeria is business because there are challenges in every area. The flip side of every challenge are business opportunities. Necessity is the mother of invention. Nigeria, we don't have water. So if you're in water business, you'll be eating food. If you do security, if you have a drone that can monitor your children all over the place, people will buy it. Because they need it. So what is not doing? Everything is problem everywhere. So because there are problems everywhere, business opportunities. The flip side of any existing challenge in society is a business opportunity. Therefore, Nigeria, nay Africa, is a land full of what? Hunger and poverty, agribusiness and food provision, acute power shortage, power and energy business, insecurity. Overseas people who speak for years, life not hang. When I wanted to speak to them about Africa, in Maui, in the USA, I told them, if it were Nigeria, that would pay me to pay on for the food to come as I went. Do you know they would eat 7:15 a.m. in the morning, 1 p.m. in the afternoon? Food will not, you will not pray for anything. You don't pray for light. I said, here, in our program, it was a recent program for 1 month. No prayers. I said, not Nigeria. Who is holding my wife? Let her fall and die. He must pray for your wife to come back. So that's, you have to pray for everything. I don't know, pray for everything. Oh, yeah. So you can see why when people don't pray, when they ask them to pray, Lord, we thank you. So grateful for life. Why wouldn't they do this one? In Africa, I have to bank. I pray that they never should have the rest of his money before. Okay, insecurity, security monitoring gadgets, water shortages, death of investable forms. If you look, is Nicole Bank better with V? If I will advertise you, if you mean what I'm saying, I will advertise you. If you can give investable funds, a lot of people want. Do you know that if you have somebody overseas who can borrow money with a social security number and bring it to Nigeria and start lending, do you know that lending in Nigeria is sales? Go to money lenders. Who has borrowed money from money lenders for anything? How much per month? I want you to go and set up on an integrity basis. Young women, and I said, I can be giving you cleaners, I can be giving you nannies, I supply nannies that I can be held accountable for your performances. If I'm not careful, your nanny, anybody who's going to get your nanny, take picture of the person. The first day, take the person home to know the person's address. Because nanny can come and clean up your whole room and become a kidnapper agent. So if you have a friend whom you can trust that the people they give to you, they be accountable for their actions. The people will see where are they? Let's go. Your business idea and investment climate, let's go. Personal profile, what is God has given to you and your training and development? There's a lot that's been said about training and mentoring. I won't go further with it. Let's go.
Look at how you know personal profiling. What are your natural gifts? What's your revelation? What do you see? If you see yourself playing football, if you, I'm talking to you for young people, I'm talking about to see young people.
Yes.
What you see regularly, maybe have a point that the God has called you. Joseph kept seeing himself. Kept himself, seeing himself being a leader. Not when you have malaria, when you have malaria, you see yourself as well. How are you living? Marist Brothers Juniorate. Your people see Dragon, your peers will tell you one thing. When they reinforce, your peers are the first to identify and give your gift. When they call you, you say, who will speak for us? I say, this man will speak for us. There's something they saw. For them to say you are not even able to speak for them. It has an impact on what God has called you. In you cannot do well except in the area of your calling. And that's the problem we have in Nigeria. Everybody wants to be everywhere. You cannot be innocent. Innocent, yeah, they think he went to the proper school, but the man is a businessman. He can't. He's in his fingers. I got to go into, I killed his wife. It was his wife that got him to you. And all that. That's his gift. Find your own area of gift. Can see JJ say, I'm not an attack. I'm not a man of words. I play with my legs. Find your area. If you don't profile yourself and find your area of calling, you'll be wasting your time. This man was so far ahead in engineering, but he's a first class man.
Yeah.
Once he takes my microphone, people start laughing, and you feel at home. That's his calling. Next one. How to develop in training, informal listings, that most people have said on this. What? Traveling. Let me tell you. Hello? Are you still there?
Yes.
Do you know? That's where we don't look. We are not very good at. You must understand the power of travel. Hello? I used to take my students to the industrial sector to expose them. When they went to the men's building, we got a certain floor, UBA. I took them. They came down. I had to go to the stock exchange, they came down, we went to Lagos Business School. Do you know I stopped teaching to them to read when they came back?
Everybody. Yes.
If you've not seen an upstairs, you cannot meet an upstairs.
Yes.
Take your children to some places. When they go there and come back, you've done magic. Yes. So people say to you, traveling, I spend money. That's the problem with the woman. By the time he's ready to enjoy those people, they say, God does to make this dark and make this issue that we need. This building is where we don't travel. Do you know an indicator, major indicator overseas that you're a rich man is if you can go on holiday with your family?
Yes,
that's a major indicator that you're a wealthy person. But here, how many still go to bed? Now, if you want to know whether your business is strong, stay here. These are factors that will help you to know. If you succeed, what's the best for risk, profitability, attractiveness, sustainability? These are criteria for assessing a business idea that will succeed. Let's go. Profitable. Start the mother house small. Let me tell you, I want people to stand here and it doesn't matter what you're doing. Make sure you have a business by the side. That business can employ one or two persons. And if all of us employ one or two persons, before you inform people who have on the streets, we need to walk our talk. Work hard and the offsets. The problem with the Enugu man, hello, we do not delay gratification. They will make one of the pioneer. I will have secondary school, I have primary school, gestation period of the school system for 10 years. I don't need to wait. That's why most of them are shutting down. Why can't I so have them all? $5, $10, I'm not changing in the AFM. Make sure business. Look at that good thing and very made to them. They started importing. They were told to do what we call backward integration. That's backward integration is when you take over the activities of your suppliers. They were given licenses. That was why they took license back from the debate. People said, well, because I didn't know. They were given the license on the premise that within 5-year period, those things you use the import, you start producing the local.
even when he was doing those things, it's possible he had some support, but he didn't damage it. But even to have difficulty, Igbo man will like it quick, fast and quick, but it's not sustainable. Anything that is fast and quick is not sustainable. Go and build a house and do shallow foundation. It's not going to carry you far. You need to change that mindset. Things will last. You must work hard and lay better foundation. Persevere in the face of harassment. Avoid unclean spirits. Let me tell you. You are doing ICT. By the time you pay your dues and the results are about to come, hey, you dropped into property. Like, property is happening, my friend. So, property is happening. Before property, you dropped into education. Stay one place, pay your dues. People are in the property. You stay here for 5 years, they won't sue one property. You have actually been here. But all the people who have, am I no property? The Marist Brothers man all over the property person. And one day I see property and I took my 300 plots somewhere. And that's okay. We laid that one. Only now just an ICT. I said you are going to join the property. I keep telling my people, stay in your place. Stay where you are called. Patiently mature the business to fruition. Periodically review your methods. And see how other things are moving in the right direction. Let's go. Let's go. Now, here, the world has gone digital. I tell my colleagues, you can't reverse back the hand. You cannot make this manualize it. You can't manualize this any longer. It has left us. Online education, online sales, online, everything has gone digital. We must ask. Hello.
Hi.
That's why our education has become more important. Education, you market that the world is running. You are training people to get into the world that is running and you're market time. Look at online sales, advertisement and social media, financial services, research and data mining. Let me tell you, we now have a future workforce that stay and work more in America. There was work I did with Oxford University. Oversee the medical students. I stayed there and we did the research together. Everything online. They paid me pounds. The world has gone digital. You can stay here and work and say, Lord, federal workforce. Approve credit. Approve everything. We go physically to those things once in a while. The world has gone digital. Let's tell our young people, go online. If you do shoot, stamp it and put it online. I've been raising money for my faculty to change the face of my faculty. You don't need to move around. Where I bought or not I bought. It's only the account people that I bought. Let's go. Now this is where I'm. Maybe if I finish this one, I can stop. Creating wealth through building social capital. We just graduated some people from the first part of Doctor of Business Administration in a UN Business School. And I told them, your major takeaway is not the certificates. Two major takeaways, your knowledge and relationships. You are what you are because of your relationship. What you be tomorrow is a function of relationship. I'm here because my own beautiful is my friend and my brother. I'm also a project PhD scholar. When I was a junior student at first, there was a young lady who came in my office. He said, I'm going to every marriage, every wedding, so that they will see me. Whose son is looking for who to marry? I have had countless number of people who have said, can I get a good woman? So the little place you are in, shine. Shine. And the way I describe it for young people, young girls, you know how I describe it. If I take one now, and give you some. If I throw mango, ripe mango, I throw the mango to you, at you, what would you do? You dodge. My brother. The first thing you do is to dodge. Before you now look at it. But if you see a ripe mango there, what would you do?
If you lose wealth, you lose nothing. If you lose health, you lose something. If you lose your character, you lose.
Let me tell you, the problem we have is not there. It's not anything about our character. Our value system needs to be structured. The little thing we are doing, not just for I, a few other persons in the business faculty, is showing up that the world is waiting for those who can be trusted. God is also waiting for those who can be trusted. Build relationship. If I do business with him, can I be trusted? That's all. I went overseas. My cousin came. He said, "This is my uncle. Uncle, I've been building all my houses. I've managed close to more than 100 million for him." Yeah. Even if I don't have work and I go there and say, I'm tired. If you give me something, give me the we'll do the bill of quantity. If I build for you, I take 5% of whatever it is. I will go work. Most of them have come here and contest suicide because they like me. But we give you a job for a big deal. People have had issues. So if you have if you're honest and you have nothing else, you will not go work. And then let me tell you, people say, "I don't have money to start business." Let me tell you, you can start business without money. All you need to. You know, when I became the dean, I called the Onog, Obi Onog, the Prime Secretary of House, who happened to be my student AMD. So I called him. He came and spoke to my people. Because of relationship with people who had made it. Relationship can change anything. While I was there, I called the AG Homes. I happened to be an accessible person. I said, "If you don't have money and you want to go, I'll call Dr. Yang Mogu, who is an access bank regional person. I'll call Chaka, who is my PhD person, who is the VA regional person. I'll call them. All relationships. You are as wealthy as the relationship you keep. Yeah. Give me money. People have been saying, let me join you to do business. I said, "Hold on, let me try it first. I don't want to raise you." Because they believe in you. If you have skills and you are honest, people will give you money. It unlocks the creative life for you. I can borrow building materials as I was building for my people. I can run into millions without one cup because of previous social capital.
Yeah.
It guarantees you captive customers and clientele. There's a woman that I buy come somewhere there. If I come on Thursday, whatever she gives to me, I'll go home with it. I know the best. I can close my eyes and eat whatever she gives to me. Integrity. Social capital. Posterity can never lead to survival. My children, I called them and said, "Look, you are going to one is a backwalk, one is a man, and so on. Nobody can harass you. I've been teaching for 20 something years, I've not harassed anybody. Nobody will. If you principles of life, whatever man saw it. Let's go. I think that's. I'll stop here.
Please can we go for Prof. I wish that Prof. would stop. He has been at everything. You will not come here and say that you did not take something from Prof. I took more than enough. Yes, I know my senior Korean team
here that is intended to give honor to whoever is due. And it says, "A word of appreciation to David Ago Esquire for his support as a resource person at the maiden XJAYS International Business Summit Association, dated 29 to 30 October 2021.
For Professor Kingsley Muoghalu, who is obviously absent. So, I believe you can receive in this.
Back to my son, on quote. Mo do mo a wo do no mo.
And he says a word of appreciation to Honorable Engineer Ambrose Mood for his support as a resource person at the Maiden XJAYS International Business Summit and exhibition dated today, 29th to 30th October 2021. Prof told us about relationship, and I personally have built one today. So, Prof, I will take your number. There are some numbers that when you have them in your phone, you go and hide the weather phone. I'm from Lagos. I will take his number and I will ensure my phone with Absat Mansard. I'm going to make claims of, I don't know, if that phone gets lost. So, Prof, maybe I will take your phone number later, please. Thank you.
In front of the governor, you're supposed to say, Akuzomu the Abakiliki war. I don't need no governor. No fruit pop in everybody. I is right. That was my greatest mistake. Though. Please, if you attack a lot of money. I'm a little bit, we are coming back. We are not done with the lecture. After that, we'll come back to finish our lectures and then we'll wait for the night. The ladies too. You have to no fruko, no flag to the ground. Enjoy yourself. Feel free and go there. Adana Fija. Adana Fija. Ijele wine. Uge be solid affair. Yes. The only lady that can be trusted on air. The only lady that says the truth. Ijele wine of solid affair. Christy Ejiofor. You're welcome. Give me the shot. Rise on this road, all the world in sun. Welcome. My dream is so empty. Yes, we move outside. DJ, bring it up, bring it up. Yes. Who is coordinating so that we can go around? Please, let's take a picture, group picture. Can we take it?
Sharp. XJAYS.
What's the last?
Marist.
XJAYS. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Honku Emmanuel, aka Mo. This is my stand. My business name is Beyond Interiors. You know why Beyond Interiors? Because my interiors are beyond your imagination. After our, when we get to your house, we'll deal on curtains, duvets, center rugs. We pimp your house to your taste.
You know,
and I won't forget to mention a few of us here that have supported my business. In the person of Daniel, has given me a job worth more than 3 million
naira.
Our provincial has given me a job. I'm the person that furnished the brother's provincial house here in Enugu. So my quality, I'm assuring you, my duvets, they are of best quality. They don't wash out. They paint, the colors. You can use it from now to anywhere we get here. Our curtains are made of high quality. Please, I plead with you all to patronize my business. Thank you very much. Thank you. XJAYS.
Maris.
XJAYS. Beautiful. And his agents, that's the spirit. That's the relationship. Meloba. Baseball Solutions. Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Excuse me. Sorry.
Please, I forgot to mention my when you, I've done a job in Ghana. Last 2 years, I fixed a company there. I separated a house there in Ghana. So my boss, my corporate office is Okana Brasil. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Meloba Bespoke Solutions. We do security solutions from video surveillance, CCTV, access control, electric fencing, home automation, wow, name it.
Wonderful.
Now, the thing with us is we do not do every type of work. If you want the best, I insist. If you don't, if you want something that is average, then we won't deal. But if you want a solution that is designed for you, that's why we are known for doing bespoke solutions. We just delivered 168 IP audio surveillance in Juniorate. We are talking about a solution where it is covered with fiber cable over a distance of 1 kilometer. This is a solution that can cover the whole state, statewide. So if you need the best video surveillance solution, home automation, Meloba is the name you need to call. Thank you.
Where's your location?
My location is Nigerian, because I finished solutions in Port Harcourt, in Owerri, in Okigwe, and currently in Enugu doing solutions, so you can reach me anywhere. Thank you.
Of course. Thank you very much. Does it detect bad effect?
No,
for free. No,
it's
from
Port Harcourt.
XJAYS.
Maris.
XJAYS.
Maris.
And that is in of 1986
says,
in
our world,
a junior, and a DOT of the I will present then a Telebay Nigerian Limited, and we are sold into an aluminium world, metronic, and food, and every cuisine. People who are included in the building construction industry know that aluminium world is always important, and we are contesting seriously. We work with mainly legalists. That's a high quality profile in the Western Coast. And then in Port Harcourt, a lot of projects are not closed up. We are based in Port Harcourt, have a ready workshop in Port Harcourt, and other works outside. Currently, we are working at the people who know space going on now. And that's where we operate always. We work on site. If the site is big, we work on site. But in March, now, who did a golf estate in Port Harcourt?
That was about 150 million. We need a total competitive estate in Abuja. That's 65 duplexes. So, a lot of other them are there. So, that's the capacity. We are more like 300 grand.
XJAYS.
Did you say anything about the t-shirt?
Yeah. The t-shirt is for wonderful chapter of the XJAYS. That's the Patakos chapter.
Hi, okay. Rodia.
The way you make them feel.
And they're mad.
Consultant.
Okay.
Is that
1 minute? I'm about to speak. Okay, my name is Hilary.
Sorry.
The managing partner, Kiltonic Drinks International.
Oh, that's good.
We are chilling Irish whiskey representative from South Nigeria. It's only interesting to inform you people that we are in the entertainment industry. The only difference is that we don't do too much noise. Our whiskeys are not aged, but in the testing, we always call results for yourself. We are not in competition with anybody. We are just there to make whiskey lovers have fun. It's only why that I opened this case, because some people will think we are parading empty containers. I had to start with this, because this is the single malt, which is like the senior brother in the Trinity. It doesn't mean necessarily that it's the highest end, because there are some of our drinks that we need escort to bring out. But these ones are easily carried around. This is single grain.
Okay, then
this is the middle one. Quite affordable. And this is for everybody. The name is Small Batch. So if you're a whiskey lover and you want to have a feel of telling whiskey, you can stop over later in the evening. For those who understand whiskey, no, you can't do that under the sun. What can I do? It's good to everybody say that we are happy to be here. This is a maiden edition of XJAYS International Business Summit. We will take it from strength to strength and we will go international about it because we already have international chapters. So we don't think we want to continue playing in the local league. Thank you very much and see you people later in the day because we'll catch you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Business before pleasure.
Izuago.
It's a champagne that comes from the French family. Well refined, it's beautiful. If you're a champagne lover, you should have castor wine. We have the rose, and we have the so, if you're a champagne lover, just come around in the evening and you'll be glad that you did. So, we have other wine, we need all kinds of wine. But right now, we are here, castor. And castor is well refined, premium wine for the French family. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Location. Okay.
Where is the Kenny? Tell us what you are doing.
Over.
Don't you do it all this well?
Welcome to UB20 International Olympic Stand. We congratulate the XJAYS International for the successful organization of the maiden edition of the Business Summit. I am only going to be in this. But don't try and wait. So keep appreciating God and keep appreciating the people. Then coming to what we have here. We have Stella Berry Sandy, Stella Berry Tomato, and Atlanta Sandy. We have to know that when it comes to Sandy, there are so many types.
We have China sardine. We have Morocco sardine. We have Thailand sardine. The best has always been Morocco sardine. Now, the Morocco sardine that everybody is conversant with is Titus.
Yes.
So, Titus has been in the market, he's enjoying the pioneer benefits. But we are coming up and we are not shaking. Stella Berry and Atlanta is having better quality than pioneer. We are not shaking. We know that the industry is tough, but because we are confident enough, we trust the number of people we have in the SJ community. I believe with you much, we can actually dominate. So here can I do play our best quality number one selling point on our sardine in healthy oil. That healthy oil is number one. How in our sardine? Now, madam, now you need the option of ordinary vegetable oil. Now you need the option of sunflower oil. Now you need the option of
heart-friendly oil.
Heart-friendly, but I'm coming. Now you need the option of oil with omega-3. So we went for omega-3. And when you want to go for omega-3, I go for the best. I know idea that your heart will thank you. So that guy will be... another selling point, when you are the norm in the Nigerian business environment, as you are coming in, you come with something big, something then with time. So we've seen how the pioneer has kept on
increasing.
So we are not going to reduce. The second selling point is that we have plenty of fish.
Yes,
so you need to pay.
Okay.
This is a very big challenge we are taking on. If I pioneer like Ogati Barahu, that is why we are seriously banking on volume. The number of people I know in our SJ community. I want to need patronage at this school. I believe in your guys and in those. I want to have
yes, so.
Buy from us. And we keep pledging our support to the SJ International. I am a good I with this power. I am a good I with this level.
Because
Ego now is here now. Those are the pioneers in the area, 700 naira. But our own, they are as low as 500 naira.
Oh, are they very good?
One carton is 20,000. Understand? But one carton is 26. A carton is 26. 50 pieces. 50 things. And I'm not selling point. I will know longer shelf life. Expiry date is now 2025. So people buy from us.
What's the difference between Atlanta and Stella Berry?
Atlanta and Stella Berry is, you know, in the market, sometimes people they win this. Nigerians they win this inborn attack. Kind of join the product. So when you come with one product, some people they want some reservation. They may attack. So you come with two. So when they are attacking one,
they will be promoting the other one.
Yeah. I don't mind.
The best quality tomato you can have.
How much is the carton? The carton is 400 grams, 12,000, 2 kg, 20,000. So that is our location is Aba.
Lagos,
OGV, Port Harcourt.
So why are our
location? We are
getting OGV. We are flying.
We are flying. Investment Limited stand. Mezefi Investment House Limited stand. Is a civil engineering construction company. The CEO is Engineer Chimete Mahamike. The general manager is KK Chidoze.
And X,
and they are both of them MKs.
Yes.
And international PRO.
But the investment limited for business is preliminary construction. It has involved so many developments across the country. Even though we are based in Port Harcourt, have projects in so many places, Abuja, Anambra, so many places. We have done quite a lot of things. I'm specifically very unique about the need of the present situation is that they are involved in the development of real estate revenue. Real estate development is what I call where the very smart and standing in the record energy. Record estate is a very special and very unique because of the nature of the environment where this estate is being developed. In fact, it is where water was pursued and then converted to land. And houses have to stand up on that area instantly. And we didn't need people who are not capable to handle that. We just made sure Investment Limited was found to be in fact they have developed quite a number of buildings they completed and handed over. Currently they marketed and watched who can handle what they need, and then that particular estate actually. And why they were looking for the specific people to be involved, the city was chosen, and is currently developing their fixed. And they are very happy with that.
Yes, Tieba.
The equipment, you sell this?
Yeah. This is our ancillary services to provide
headgear? Are there
headgears? Not necessarily, but headgears, but this one is just construction support services. But they are special ones, in that we made in category both fire resistant and the ordinary. We have made fire resistant again because fire breaks out anywhere, anytime without notice. So that if we are with this,
Maris.
Please, would that be biased? I want to give you one living testimony. Respect to the same field and his
construction. SS Group.
There are many failed buildings these days as a result of technical errors. One problem or the other. But there's one thing I want to know, not to identify today about the same field. It's one thing that you can cross. In terms of integrity, in terms of packaging and deliverance, in terms of sincerity of purpose in everything, I am a beneficiary. The little development I am trying to put up in the village, they just gave me all that is needed. In the spirit of Asia for Asia, you never ask me for more. XJAYS,
Maris.
XJAYS,
Maris.
Maris.
XJAYS.
Maris.
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 I'm going to go to the hospital.
Nna, ịmụ ịgba ezigbo ya. Ịgba anya. Testing test.
Made in Nigeria.
Yes.
That's good.
Yes.
This is the best.
I want to
market it. And one special thing that connects this brand with XJAYS is that I have at least 4 or 5 distributors that I started this product with that are XJAYS. And without them, I don't think that this product will be where it is today. That's why I'm a staunch supporter of XJAYS. And I will always support XJAYS business before any other business. I don't have much to say. Thank you very much. I thank God for this platform. I thank my able president for presenting us to this platform. I thank my able chairman for setting this platform. And thank you very much.
Beautiful. What are we going to? Please remember, as we're walking around here, traffic bus station is there free. Go and take the service. So, Engineering Limited. I beg you. Okay, your son. Okay.
Carbon can.
Yeah, there's a good
carbon can.
Local content, 100%.
Engines, Marist. Engines, Marist. Marist, engines.
This is Champion Engineering Limited. Now,
Flyover. That is the man behind it.
That's where I was.
So many.
12 years as a supervisor. Now this is our own company. We're into construction. We're into procurement. We're into civil engineering contracts. We're into consultancy. And more especially.
More especially. We into project management.
We can take care of your project
from inception to completion. We can also advise. We can tell you what it looks like on the return of investment, which is what is
Hikachamba for every investor. They want to know how they can get the money back.
How many years you will take them to get their money back? So we can also advise you on project management.
And by my course, I read project management technology,
better industrial technology, ever on my ground.
Yes.
On project management.
Okay, ma.
So, what you can see us display
was some of our projects.
Yes. The one here is a 2 kilometer
road name for
Imperial College of Agriculture, Ishiago. This was done in 2016, and it's still standing now. Down here, you have our project at the University of Nigeria, Nsukka campus. Before we built the Institute of African Studies, this is one of the buildings, this is Cultural Center. As you can see, Obido from foundation through to finishing, and it has been commissioned. At the other side, too, we displayed the auditorium of the same University of Nigeria, Nsukka. They are all big buildings,
gigantic buildings,
very challenging in the engineering design and construction, as you can see. Then some of this also is,
you can see our equipment displayed. Most of the pictures are taken when they are being deployed on the site. If you can see this is just the outline on the site. Maybe after construction, we'll just mark them and take the picture.
This is a road project we did at Ibibwe, in Enugu State, and Enugu local government in Enugu State. As you can see, it's not the local content. We are good in building construction. We are also good in building construction. Anything we want us to do, partnership.
You want us to partner with you to develop our project,
like I said, we are very good with program management. We want to help you do that. Thank you very much.
Honorable.
XJAYS,
XJAYS,
Marist,
this is Peter Paul's two people. By the special grace of God, I'm seeing we are manufacturers of organic and we produce this from scratch. The basic problem here in Bama, if you look at this stage, as a
from this point, not that it cannot be, but Nigerians want something that is very
strong. I'm tasting Amaka.
That is very long chain. Why you say this Amas is the best? So far, there are only five companies in Nigeria. Fortunately, we are the only one out. Another two is government, which are not functioning. Then, if you look at this, our state, one of the major differences is that because it's our bamboo, it comes from this natural habitat. It is not ordinarily planted. The ones I Chinese do, they don't actually wait for the bamboo to get mature. They will harvest it. That is why most times when you eat their own, or some of their own, bring the leaves. This is why you can even have it, you can have it ready to your own yard from your teeth. Then, another interesting thing about this is that there is what we call sterilization. There is what we call sterilization process of this food. The ones Chinese do, they sterilize the chemical that is harmful for the sheep. And that is what they shut down. Because our standard of operations are not working well, so we don't have options being accepted in Nigeria. If you travel far, you will discover that the thing they use here is not the same thing that is being used in America or Europe. Why? Because their standard of operations works, and Chinese cannot send or ship to them the one that is not well sterilized. Why we chose this one? Why we chose to do the perfect sterilization are two things. One, we want it to be very much standard. Another thing is, by the way, when we went to China to learn this process, because the sterilization of the water is still excellent, they can't do that. So we don't even, and even if we do it, we don't even have this one is the normal ones we produce. We are selling this one well. This
one, we are still looking forward to see if we can get contact on some of these retailers like ShopRite, Spa, and thereabout. That's why we are speaking to the XJAYS. Anyone that has such contact, please help us. We can display our products here, like Roban is already selling, and Global Supermarket is already selling. Again, we also have a recent application to CPA for intervention because we want to expand. So far, nothing has been done. So we are also seeking for contact, people who can help us, people who can help us, maybe that we have to get the federal government intervention so that we can actually expand our program. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Maris.
Good afternoon, all.
Afternoon.
This is the stand for Lance Ayach and Co. Estate surveyors, valuers, and
organizers.
We are into property valuation, property management, facility management, property development, and development. We are into agents for all purposes. Actually, most of us don't know what valuation is, but it is determining the value of a property for different purposes at a particular time. Ike and Ayaj, being the principal partner, is a fellow of the institution. And as an announcement, it's a council meeting of the institution. That's why he's not here on the ground. So, and he's the Abuja president of the institution. And he's also the Abuja chairman of the institution. So far that we are working, those of you that work with organizations and that is good at what he's doing. Thank you.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Maris. My name is Edmond Maduwihe. I'm the director of EDX Stones.
When it comes to granite, I mean, we made purely Nigerian granite, very solid and very strong.
From what we can talk about, the best company in the year, stronger than what you can get even in from Chinese and India. We also build these are stones for wall, external wall. We have bricks. So we also do landscaping too, 3D, inkwell, so many more. I know there are so many engineers here who can attest to what I've done for them in their company, their houses too. So our head office is in Abuja, Day Market, and also in Fox Road. Thank you.
My flyer.
They are sharing you.
We also have the world's
Do consultancy for tech fund, and we do for universities and colleges of education. We have worked with Abia State University, where we consulted for most of their department units. We have also done so in Federal College of Agriculture in Seattle, and in construction. Majority of the construction work we have done recently is for the Marist Brothers. If you go to the new polytechnic in MNM, we did the ICT and library building.
Back in their business, most of them shut down. You know, so we offer you that tech support to enable your business with technology so that even if you are not there physically present or your shop is not physically open, people will still be able to reach you and be able to patronize you and get services delivered to them. The other area we also offer support is business advisory. You know, we know that a lot of us are into businesses, but not a lot of us know the required laws and regulation regulating our areas of business. It's important that you always get an expert to support your business and give you advice from time to time on how to do some things, so that it's not when you want to expand or when you want to move into another location, you start having issues with government. So we also offer business advisory to help you grow and expand your businesses. Then the last but not the least is investments. We help you also grow your wealth.
So when you invest with us, you give us your money, maybe fixed deposit for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 1 year. We give you high rates of return on the investment. I'm not sure any bank gives as high as it will do as high as 15% around. The best part is that all of this is backed with technology. If you open our app, you see that you can actually set up this fixed deposit on yourself at your convenience any time of the day and put the number of days or months you want it. And even when you want to liquidate as a children account. And the good part again is that we don't just help you save the money, we also offer interest on children accounts. So whatever amount you put, we offer interest on it. And again, we don't even wait for the end of the tenor to give you the interest, we pay you the interest money. So if that 15%, we don't wait to the end of the year to pay you. Every month you get what is due for that month, and you can even access it from the way you want up until the end of the tenor. There's any questions?
Any questions?
So what if I stay in Port Harcourt, I know I opened an account with Big Bank, and how can I get my debit card?
Okay. Thank you it's a very valid question. So we operate as a digital bank. This means, like you said, a lot of our operations are online. Or even inside the app, you see where you can request for your debit card to answer your questions specifically. And when you are requesting, you select the state and you put your address. And once the card is ready, we'll deliver it to your house or your office. So you don't need any physical. But in addition as well, just to add that we're also processing our national license. We're almost done with our process. So very soon you'll also be seeing us in places outside Lagos.
So is a debit card going to work in other ATMs?
Yes. It's just like every other debit card you have. It works ATM, POS, online for payments on online. Even internationally it also works outside Nigeria. Thank you very much. Any more questions there? Let's go to COVID 19 vaccination.
Automatically you are inducted.
You have been
with this thing. Our chairman is back.
Yes.
Welcome, sir.